So from today, we have to start with that the France of the old regime, and in the France old regime, the monarch did not have the power to impose taxes according to his will alone. Means the monarch means the king. Means the monarch or the king, or we can say whatever the number of the Louis. From here we start with the Louis XVI. So in which way he imposed the taxes, but he can't impose the taxes alone. Means he have to gather and take the suggestion of many of them. Means they have to join the meeting of the first state, second state and third states. So after this meeting, he will impose the taxes. And the meeting where this is going to be, this is known as Estates General. This is the Estates General. In this Estates General means everyone represents means the first state, the second state and the third state. Means all the representative have to participate in this. So in this way, the monarch alone could decide when to call a meeting to this body. The last time it was means before to start this was occurred very earlier, and the time was 1614. After this we can say, after this on 5th May 1789, after 1614, after long gap, means on the 5th May 1789, this Estates General was called, and this meeting, the general to pass proposals of the new taxes. Means now the monarchy decided to how to impose the taxes on the third state, because we know earlier that only the third state pay the tax and another first and the second state enjoy all the privileges and they were exempted from the taxes. So where this meeting is going to be held, so we have to write this where the meeting is going to be held. This place was Versailles. And this meeting is going to be a splendid hall, was prepared to host the delegates. Means every states, we have written earlier, the first state, second state and the third state is available in this meeting, and they represented, and they are representing all these three states, the first state, second state and third state. So the number of the first state, and the number of this representative near about means 300, and the third state's representative consists 600 members, and in the 600 everyone is included in this, and they are from the each background. Means they have also come from the peasants, farmers, merchants, traders, bankers, philosophers and everyone. But the three peoples in this who are not allowed to participate, and they were peasants, peasants, then artisans, and women. They were not allowed to participate in this meeting. But it doesn't mean they are not available in this meeting, but their grievances and their sorrows were presented in this meeting by the method of they have given near about 40,000 letters. They have given the 40,000 letters which represent all of them. And in these letters, their grievances, sorrow, grief, and everything is given to them. So now, when the king rejected the proposal, as you know about the first state, second, and the third state, every state have the power to give the one vote or whatever. It means the last at the last point, the third state, they don't have too much power because they have consist only one vote. So the representative of the third state viewed themselves as a spokesman for the whole French nation. Means from this time, means from the 5th May. We have written about this earlier. 5th May 1789. From this time, the people thought from the different perspective. Now they think they are just not only just state, they have also the power to do something in this manner. So on the 20th June, they assembled in the hall. So what they have done for this? On 20th June, remember the dates? Earlier the 5th June, now this is the 20th June. On the 20th June, they assembled in the hall of an indoor tennis court in the grounds of the Versailles. They declared themselves of the National Assembly. We can say the third state now changed the name and it's become the National Assembly. So they had declared themselves a National Assembly and swore not to do disperse till they had, means that telling they are not going to be dispersed until they will make or they will draft a new constitution. Draft a new constitutions. And this constitution will be in the favor of the third state. Because we know that earlier what happened to them? That it will happen that they will not enjoy the privileges, means they are not enjoy the privileges, as well as the first and the second state impose their taxes on the third states. So in this manner, they want to get rid out of them from the entanglement of the first and the second states. So they do the sins. So they were led by the means the next point is this: the third state was led by whom? And the two persons have a very great famous persons who led this movement, and their name was they led this movement and their name was Mirabeau, and the next one is Abbe. Abbe Sieyès. They both belong from the noble background, means they are consisting from first and the second states. So the Mirabeau is born in the noble family but was convinced of the need to do away with the society of the feudal privileges. Means he was born in a noble family, means he belonged from the first and whatever you can say second states, but his thinking is different from those persons who belong from the first and the second states. So that's why he was thinking in the favor of the third states. And the next person is Abai Sais. He belonged from the clergy class. The Abai Sais, originally a priest, wrote an influential, and he wrote a book which is known as Third State. What is Third State? He wrote a book which name is What is Third State? As well as I told you that Mirabai belonged from the normal family and Abai Sais is belong from the clergyman class. Clergyman, it means he belong from the church, or we can say he is a belong from a church class. So they both belong from the normal family, but their feeling for the third state is different from the others. So that's why they are thinking in a sympathy manner for the third state. So while the National Assembly was busy at the Versailles drafting a constitution, the rest of the France seethed with the turmoil. Clear? Next one. After spending hours in a long queues, while the National Assembly was busy at Versailles drafting a constitution, the rest of the France seethed with turmoil. Means the turmoil means the condition is turmoil. Turmoil means the condition of great chaos. Chaos means what is going to be had after this revolution. Means it is a very tense situation at this time. So we have read about this, what the situation at the time of the French Revolution was there. So after spending, means we have read about the great, we can say, drought in the France, and when there was a drought, automatically the increasing prices of food grains, and this food grains, and most of this when there is a shortage of the food grains, so they were standing in the long queues at the shops, at the bakery shops. This is the situation why the French Revolution occurred. There, so we have talked about this. There was drought, the economic crisis, and this, all this situation assembled and gathered and make a pivotal role to make the French Revolution. So drought, bakery shops, what they have done? The bakers hoarded the supplies of the bread and the butter. And the people were standing in a long queues. Means, simple sense, आपको थोड़ा सा बता दें हिंदी में कि सिचुएशन बहुत टेंस थी और ड्रॉट की वजह से, ड्रॉट ऑटोमेटिकली आपको पता है कि सूखा पड़ा था, मतलब फूड ग्रेन्स की कमी थी और बेकरी शॉप्स, तो आपको पता है कि बेकरी शॉप्स पे ब्रेड मिलती है, तो सो द पीपल आर स्टैंडिंग इन दिस लॉन्ग क्यूज एंड द पीपल वर टेंस बिकॉज स्टिल आफ्टर स्टैंडिंग इन द लॉन्ग क्यू दे कांट गॉट द bread. I am writing above here. There means the bakery shops, the people are standing the queues. The still after this long queues, what they have done? The bakers hoarded the supply. The bakers hoarded the supply. And when they hoarded the supply, the bakers, the people, what the people have done? The people have looted the bread and the butters. So this one. So after spending hours in the long queues at the bakers, crowds of the angry women stormed into the shops At the same time, the king ordered troops to move into the Paris. So we have read start where when you started the lesson, you have read from this scenario. This is the scene at that time. So you can join this timing or the scene with this. So why this happened to this? So this was the background of this. Why this situation going to be, and why the king ordered the troops. When you start at this point, we have read about this. Earlier we start this on the 5th of June or 5th of May, why the king ordered the troops. This was a situation as there. So in the countryside, rumors spread from village to village. Means earlier this was the period or place of, we can say, the urban areas. But this situation is going to be the rights, means dange, matlab bread or butter ke liye jo dange ki situation thi pehle shehron mein hui aur shehron se hoti hui pehle eastern France ke sites mein hui aur uske baad se ye situation takriban all over France mein spread kar gaya. This was the situation. While how the rights were spread from place to place and from the urban areas to the other countrysides. Clear? So in the countryside, rumors spread from village to village that the orders of the manor had hired bands of the brigands who were in their way to destroy the ripe crops caught in the... So this was the situation. So the faced with the power of his revolting subjects, the Louis XVI finally accorded recognitions. So after seeing this situation, what the King 16, or we can say the Louis 16, had decided. Now they have given the order, recognized the National Assembly. Means the king recognized the National Assembly. How the king recognized the National Assembly. This is the king. Now, after this, when the situation is going to be tense and understood by the king, is nothing to be going against to the third states. Now, he recognized the National Assembly. So this one, faced with the power of this, so we have discussed about this. On the 4th August 1789, means what happened after the 4th August 1789, you have to remember about the dates, 5th of May, 20th of June and the 4th of August. Write it at some place at what date, what thing was happened or occurred. Because these dates are very essential. On the nights of the 4th August 1789, the assembly passed a decree abolishing the feudal system of obligation and taxes. Means on 4th of August 1789, what the king ordered to abolish. The king ordered to abolish the feudal system. So most of you familiar with the feudal system. What is the feudal system? Yes, beta.
In feudal system, sir, जब wars होते थे तो सर जो king होता था, जो लोग उनके लिए काम करते थे, तो जो king उनको land देता था, सर इसी को feudal system बोलते हैं.
Yes, even in the class 7th, you have read about this, the feudal system. in the Iktadari system is related with the Indian system, with the Iktadari. The feudal system is nothing. Because if you system about the channel or the process in the feudal system, at the top, there was a king. After this, there was a different nobles. Or we can say, at the short of the currency, means at the time we know about, there is a lack of the currency. So in this manner, the king distributed the land to the other nobles. And these nobles are known as other, we can say in other country, known as the duke. At the some points, it is known as earls. So he distributed this land to them, the duke and the earls. And the duke and earls collect the money from the common peasants or the artisans or whatever it. And they, after collecting this money, they have given this collecting money to the king in simple manner. So this is the feudal system. So in this feudal system is the binding system. And this old system was crushed or abolished by the king. Understood? So this one. So the France become the constitutional monarchy. At this time, the France will become a constitutional monarchy. So we have, in the outbreak of a revolution, we have read this point. Now in the next point, we have discussed about the other things, because from last two or three days, we are at this lesson. The France becomes a constitutional so all of you familiar with what? With the constitution. If there is a constitution, it's a constitutional. So constitution means from the class 6 they have read about the constitutions. So there are some we can say articles in regarding this. So we have read about this earlier. They don't have any constitution, because earlier they have the what? The monarchical form. But still, from this time, means 4th of August, now they decided to make a constitution. So that's why the France become known as the constitutional monarchy, because still at this time, the monarchy means the king was alive. And in his presence, this constitution is going to be made. So the National Assembly completed the draft of the constitution in 1791. So drafted a constitution. And this was the period, 1791. You have to remember all these dates. Earlier talked about it, 5th May, then 20th June, then 4th August, then 1791. Means on what day, what the things was occurred or happened. Yes. The National Assembly completed the draft of the Constitution 79. Its main object was to limit the powers of the monarch. Means what their main objective? Objective of this constitutional monarchy, to limit the powers. To limit the powers of monarch. You have to write about these points. Limit the powers of monarch. Main motto or main objective, to limit the powers of the monarch. Means earlier, if the monarch or the king or the Louis 16, whatever we can say, because if you talk about the 16, they have also the ascending order from first and whatever. This time we have studying about the only Louis 16. So limit the powers of the monarch. Means they can't do anything by their own will. They have to take the permission. But earlier we have also read about, they have all taken the permission. But this was just only for the name, because they are doing this by their own wish. So these power, instead of being concentrated in the hands of the person, were now separated and assigned to the different institutions. Means the limit the powers of the monarch, means they are limited in the sense. And now these powers these powers is not only the concentrated in the one hand. Earlier it was concentrated in the one hand and the hand is monarch or the king. But this time these were enjoyed by the different organs of the government, which is known as what? What? Legislature. Then whatever we can call about this executive, and the next one is judiciary. So this one, so legislature, executive and judiciary, matlab means we have talked about earlier, this is not only concentrated in the hands of the king, these were equally distributed of this organ of the state. So next point, the constitution of 79 vested the powers made laws in the National Assembly, which was indirectly elected. This only man above means bit, but still they haven't earlier got the like a totally a democracy, because earlier the norms and laws are different. Example, the person who has completed the age of 25, they have only the power to give the right to vote. Only the men, and the 25 means, and now not the females, only the male means the men have only the power to give to vote. Only men have above 25 years age who pay taxes equal at least 3 days of a laborer's wage were given the status of active citizens, that is they were entitled to vote. Means 25 who crossed the age of 25, and after this who crossed the age of 25 and who paid the taxes, they have the right to give the vote, and they have got the what? There are two kinds of citizens in the third state, or we can say right now the third state for all the states. Now they are, this time there is not only the states, means there are two kinds of citizens. Those citizens
कुछ दबाए क्या वहां
रनिंग वाली मैम शॉर्ट दे उसको तो भी 10 मिनट्स है ना. So now we have, I am summing up this point from the means the person or the man who crossed who had just crossed the age of 25, they just have two power to give the vote, and in this there are two kinds of citizens. The one is citizens. The first one is active and another one is passive. So can anyone tell me what is the active and what is the passive?
S-
संदीप सिंह, वंशिका, आर यू लिसनिंग? So can you tell me what is the active season and what is the passive season? Who will tell me about this? The active citizens and the passive citizens. The active have the power to give the vote because they paid the taxes, so they have got the chances of the active citizen. The passive citizens, they don't have the power to vote. They can't got the power to vote. So to qualify as an elector and then as a member of the assembly, a man had to belong to the highest bracket of taxpayers. Means you have to, first of all, if you pay the taxes, then you will become the part of active citizens. Otherwise you will not have the power to give the vote, and you will count in the category of passive citizens, not in the active citizens. The constitutions began with the declaration of the right of the man. You have read about in this declaration the wants and the rights, such as right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, equality before taxes were ideas established as natural and inalienable rights. That is, they belong to each human being by birth and could not be taken away. Means the man get all about from where we start this lesson. We have started this lesson and talking about the three main notions of this lesson in the French Revolution: the freedom, liberty, and equality. So by the declaration of the right of the man, they can enjoy all these ideas or the notions. So today we'll sum up this lesson. And today we have completed the two topics: the outbreak of revolution, and the other one is France becomes a constitutional monarchy. Yes, Gyanendra. So you have understood or not?
Yes, sir, understood.
Tell me what the points you will not understood. Any point?
Sir, the power of monarchy.
The power of the monarchy, if you read about the earlier part of the feudal part, if you have little bit knowledge about the feudalism, because here we are studying about in the context of Europe. Because from the last previous classes, you have read about the Indian context. In Indian context, you have read about this. The Samans, the Mansabdars.
Yes, sir.
That system is just followed in this world of, we can say, the Europe system. Here, yes. Just the name changed. They are the landlords, feudal lords, and they also grant the lands to the other nobles who will collect the land. Who will collect the tax and give to the king. Means they are enjoying the power as a semi-independent, not the fully independent. They are semi-independent. Means in their own territory, they will become the kings. They will collect the tax, and
yes,
this tax will given to the whom? To the monarch or to the king. And the king will decide what he will do from the
with the tax
they will collect. Understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, the Sandeep Singh. Tell me, are you listening to me or not?
Yes. Sir, can you please make me understand the political system under the Constitution of 1791, which the field has given in our book?
The political system.
I didn't
the political system. If we talk about the political system, earlier the political system is totally and totally controlled by the king. But right now, from the when the in the 1790 1791 when the new constitution was drafted. Right now, the powers is controlled. And not only the control, the king was abolished from the powers. And these powers will come in the hands of the government. And it is equally distributed in the previous classes you read about this word. Legislature, executive, and judiciary. So they will enjoy this. And this will, in the previous class you read about, these are the parts of the, or this is the parts of the government. And they were done their work in their limited periphery. Means every work is defined by their own way. What the legislature will do, what the executive will do, and what the judiciary will do. You will understood? This one. Vanshika Yadav. Newcomers. Are you newcomer? Hello? Are you listening or not? Some network problem is there. So today, we'll, tomorrow we'll start with the new topics. So now you have to read the another points. If you still have any doubt, you can ask.
So no doubt, sir.
Clear all the points. It's okay because right now you are learning these points. So reading about the political symbols painting by the, if you see the page, you will find about the some political symbols. Little bit we have start this. The political symbols. Have you read about this political symbols? If you see the book, you'll find out the political symbols. Why the political, first of all, the question arises, why they have given the political symbols? Because it is very common, if you read about, just you know about this, if you read this, this is a very earlier or the beginning period, and this at this time, not too much people were literate.